Sounds good.
Okamanu. Onu uwanu.
The Phoebus, because they're a faster boat, they will start first. If we had the slower boats start, then the faster boats would have to work their way through the slower boats. And it's better because you don't have to worry about any collisions or crossing boats, faster boats or slower boats. So you always start your faster classes first. Because the 13 above class is always fairly small, because a lot of those kids have already moved up to the Phoebus, that we start both the 13 above and the 12 and under at the same start. We use two different types of boats. Open Bic is a single-handed or one-person boat, and the Phoebus is a double-handed crewed boat. The Bics, we run two classes and we divide it up by ages, 12 and under and 13 and over. Single-handed, single sail, very simple boat to sail. If they capsize, you just pull it up and go. There's no bailing because it's got an open stern. Great little boat for smaller kids. The Phoebus, kind of a modern answer to a widely used boat throughout the U.S. and probably other parts of the world called a 420. It comes from England. It's got a mainsail, a jib, and an asymmetrical spinnaker or chute. Real nice boat, pretty tough. It's a good first boat for those kids that want to sail with somebody else. Get into a crewed situation, you start working with each other and rely on each other. Sail the boat and making tactical and strategic decisions on what you should do all around the course and at the start line. The Phoebus are fun to watch. They're very colorful boats. What's interesting about them is that going to weather, they've got just the two sails up, but when they come around the weather mark, then they've got to get the chute up, and sometimes a crapshoot, if it's going to go up okay and fill and they take off, and it gets stuck and they've got to deal with that. But and then once they get it up, then the crew is continually trimming that to make sure they've got good boat speed. But they're a fun boat to watch race. We set up seven courses. We've got four buoys out. We've got seven options on how you can sail around those buoys. The basic course is we do a start, beat to weather, the A mark, reach across the B, run or go dead downwind to C, reach back to D, and then harden up and beat back to weather to the finish line. The shortest course, I think, is an AD finish. And that's if we got heavy wind or we're just trying to get one more race in. And there's a lot of other options in there. So two of the real hot rods in the Bic class were both Otis Buckingham and Mac Millen, and they were both sailing for Lahaina Yacht Club. These two guys duked it out all weekend. They were really going at it. They're both good little sailors. This was first regatta for both of them. Most of the kids, our kids especially, the first time we see them is in the junior classes, and a lot of them have never had any experience before, struggle for a while and it starts to click. And the ones that are interested, we recruit for the sailing team. You can see as they get more and more skilled, the more practice they get in, the faster they get, the better they get on making tactical decisions. The smart ones work as a team. Doesn't matter whether it's kids or adults, you'll always find situations where I'm the skipper and you're the crew and you do what I say. But the smart ones will be act as a team, and they're the ones that will probably win a lot more races or do a lot better in regattas. Just the way sailing is. Some of them get pretty competitive. And we're back to Mac and Otis, and they're out there duking it out some more. This has been going on all weekend. The number of races in a regatta kind of depends on the wind. If we've got a good wind up, we try to get at least six races in on Saturday and get four races in on Sunday. This year, I think the Bic sailed five, the Phoebus sailed six on Saturday, and I think both classes got three races in on Sunday before the wind pretty much died on us. little over 4 years ago, we were approached by Todd Carl of the Owyukai Boat Club, and they were racing BIX, and there were very few other clubs on Oahu that had BIX, and they were very interested having us regatta with them. And the sweetener was that one of their members works for Matson, and they would arrange for Matson to ship all our boats over. The container was free, and Matson was really great about moving boats back and forth.
Oh, okay.
And then he said, and oh, by the way, we expect you guys to reciprocate with your own regatta. So we got a team together and did all that, did the Barron's Cup, and then we organized a regatta. Owyukai came over, and we did it, I think the first one was in September, and it was a great first regatta. Here we are looking at the finish, and here comes Otis Buckingham, and Mac Millen is close behind him, and they did really well. A lot of boys and girls out there. Some of the girls are, surprisingly, are very competitive, and they're right up there giving the boys a hard time. I mean, we get some of the girls that they're taking first and seconds. It's really nice to see both groups up there having at it.
So what do you owe your success to?
I don't know. This is the second time I've sailed a FIBA.
Little pinching out there?
Yeah.
All right. The last course, a little pinching?
Yeah.
Looking good. That's the way to do it.
Yeah.
All right, Mac, what do you owe your success to?
My parents and everything. Right.
And what are your two favorite words in the English language?
Boat speed.
How do you say it?
Boat speed.
There you go.
No place I'd rather be. Of the ocean, whirlpool swirling, cascading.